with stocks in Asia seeing a mixed start to the new trading week, with investors reacting to the deal stateside to avert a potential U.S. default. The agreement reached over the weekend suspends the borrowing limit until 2025, while putting a cap on government spending in U.S. national budgets in the next 2 years. The deal will be put for a vote in Congress, but reports indicate hardline Republicans may oppose its passage.
The agreement also represents a compromise, which means no one got everything they want. But that's the responsibility of governing. And this is a deal is good news, for I believe you'll see, for the American people. The agreement prevents the worst possible crisis, a default for the first time in our nation's history. An economic recession, retirement accounts devastated, millions of jobs lost. It also protects key priorities and accomplishments and values that congressional Democrats and I have fought long for.
Looking now at major stock indices in the region, we're seeing the Nikkei 225 up 1% to lead Monday's gains. Hong Kong's Hang Seng continued to slide to new lows this year, shedding 0.8%. The South Korean Kospi, meanwhile, is closed for a public holiday. Over in Europe, futures point to a higher open still from the debt ceiling deal in the U.S. Wall Street also reacting positively to the news. All three major indices are up in pre-market open, led by the tech-heavy NASDAQ, more than 0.5%. Trading resumes tonight, Manila time. China's trade spat with the United States over memory chips intensifies. U.S. Commerce Chief Gina Raimondo tells Beijing they will not tolerate its ban on the sale of Micron Technologies products. Chinese regulators last week barred products from Micron, citing threats to national security. But Raimondo, during weekend talks for the Indo-Pacific Economic Framework, called China's move plain and simple economic coercion. She also believes the move will not succeed. In another development, South Korea says it won't encourage local chip makers to fill the market gap left by Micron in China. Seoul refuted reports it will try to capitalize on China's ban. Beijing is the biggest market for South Korean semiconductor companies Samsung and SK Hynix. A British business leader says 3 billion people may benefit from the United Kingdom's developing country trading scheme. Chris Nelson of the British Chamber of Commerce of the Philippines also says the new trading scheme, which will be launched in the Philippines on June 7, will further boost trade between Manila and London. The UK announced the DCT in 2022. It targets to include about 65 developing countries across the globe and would focus on four main products: electronics, coconut oil, spectacle lenses, as well as processed fruit. The DCT is meant to replace the European Union's generalized scheme of preferences.
DCTS will reduce significantly. It's removing, I think, 150 of the tariff lines. It will cover an area, I think, of over 3.3 billion people. And I think what it's going to do, particularly for the Philippines, is continue to grow trade that's already doing extremely well. And I think what it's going to do, particularly for the Philippines, is continue to grow trade that's already doing extremely well. I mean, already we're now at £2.4 billion, Mimi, of trade between the two countries, and it's very well balanced, 1.2 between each. So I think what we're looking for is going to focus on certain sectors. It's going to be a help, and we're looking forward to continuing growth, as I said already, from a significantly higher base, which is 2.4 billion between the two countries.